Hello and welcome back to another art video. In today's video I'm going to show you three different ways to colour a simple flower shape. Now as you can see the three flowers, they look completely different type petals, but it's actually all exactly the same basic flower shape that I've drawn. I've just copied it three times. So adding a little bit of shading, you can make the petals look a completely different shape. Like obviously this one looks like the petal comes out in the middle, like kind of towards us, towards the camera, and then it curves back in towards the middle and it curves out towards this edge here. These petals look like they're basically rounded, they just kind of come out in the middle and they're going back in right around the edge. And these ones are supposed to look more like they go in towards the middle here and then curve round a little bit at the outer edge. Okay, so I'm using Prismacolor coloured pencils. I'll tell you which colours I'm using as I'm going along. If you have a different brand, then just pick out similar colours. You can use completely different colours altogether. But if you want to follow along, they are Prismacolor pencils. And if you're using toned paper like me, they are the best pencils that you can use for toned paper because they're quite opaque. Okay, so let's get started. Okay, so I'm going to start with the red flower, and the colours that I'm going to use for the petals are Prismacolor PC195, which is pomegranate, number 926, which is carmine red, number 122, which is permanent red, and the white, which is number 938. So I'm going to start off with a little bit of white in the middle and then I'm just gonna fade that out like that, just lightly fade it out, just so that we don't have a blob with like harsh lines on the outside. So next we're going to use the carmine red and just slowly fade that in. Don't start right at the outer edge, but just start really, really lightly doing light circles around the edge of the white blob. And then just a tiny little bit over the top of it. The reason I'm putting white on is because I'm not using white paper and I want that shine in the middle of the petal. And because it's a toned paper, that won't work as well. So next I'm going to use the permanent red and I'm going to go right to the edge and then bring that in. So stronger to the edge and then bring it in towards the middle. But don't go all the way over the white part. So just do that all the way around. If you notice at this point, yeah, I can still see the paper through the pencil because I haven't pressed it really hard. But that's just the first layer, so I'll now go in with the second layer and using the carmine red again. I'm going to press a little bit harder and make that a little bit darker and then lighter towards the middle. So we don't cover all that white. I'm just gonna cover that over a little bit, but still leaving some of that white to show through, and then hard around the outsides. And then I'm going to get the permanent red again. And put more pressure on the very outside edge. And then work inwards a little bit. And then with the pomegranate, I'm going to go right around the outside, like this, and just slightly soften the edge, but don't bring it in very far, we just want it around the very edge, and then soften it, so around the very edge, and then soften it with small circles. And do that all the way around. And then just make sure that's nice and blended smoothly.
Stay, wish for this moment to never go away, but it's all in my mind, and though I know that there is nothing to find, you're a beautiful sight in the summer night, and you can't put up a fight in the misty light.
So now we're going to move on to the centre of this, and I'm going to do it black, but we want it to look three-dimensional like this one does, but I want to do a little bit of shine in the middle like I have done with the petals. So I'm going to start off with the white and do a white blob in the middle and fade it out like I did with the petals, and then with the black I'm just gonna go around that lightly, and then just very, very lightly blend that in. So there's just a light layer over the black, and then I'm gonna go around the edge. I'm gonna have a jet black on the very, very outside. And then basically just fade that in towards the middle. So it's just getting lighter and lighter as it gets into the middle. Just keep building the layers up until you get it to look right. Just be careful not to go over the middle too much. You just want that to give it a little bit of, you know, three-dimensional shape, so it looks like it's got the form where it's raising up in the middle and then going back towards the edge. Okay, so that's the first flower. So for the next one, we're going to start with, we want a kind of curved piece of white in the middle here. So there's going to be a shine in the middle and it's on a slight curve. We'll put our white in the middle. And then fade it out slightly at the edges. And then next we're going to go in with the light aqua, which is 992. And then go either side of that white strip, just put a light layer, blend it in, just do a little circular strokes to slightly blend that into the white area, and then a bit more pressure on the outside of that. And then the same on this side. And then the next colour is the aquamarine 905. And then we start off this side of the light aqua. And then slightly blend that into the light aqua, just like we did with the light aqua and the white. And then add more pressure towards this side, and then do the same on this end of the petal. Blend that in. And then very lightly blend that into the light aqua. And then the next colour is Indigo Blue 901, and we want to just add a little bit of that to the very tip of that petal, then slightly blend it, and then a bit to the bottom here. And just slightly blend it in. So I'll finish those and then we'll move on to the middle. See how you roam while you roam in the streets all alone. All you can see, thinking about what your life came to be. You're a beautiful sight in the summer night. You can't put up a fight in the misty light. so that's the petals done on that one. So now moving on to the middle, I'm going to put a little bit of white in the middle again. Fade it out. And the next colour I'm going to use is Canary Yellow 916. And I'm going to go around the outside of that. Just lightly. And just very, very lightly coating the white. And then make it a bit stronger as it goes out towards the outside. And then the next colour I'm going to use is Sunburst Yellow 917. And I'm going to colour the outside of that. And let it blend into the Canary Yellow. And then on the very outer edge, I'm going to use Goldenrod, which is 1034. And just do an outer line. And then soften that line on the inside. Okay, so that's flower number two. So for the third flower, I'm going to start with doing a line on the outside in white on the outer perimeter. And kind of just soften that line with small circular light motion. And then the next colour we're going to use is the hot pink, which is 993. I'm going to colour the middle in with that. And then we're just going to fade it into that white. Just lightly blend it into the white. And then just make the colour stronger in the middle and towards the bottom part here. Using the pomegranate, which is 195. I'm going to kind of do a line going from the middle kind of halfway, and then do smaller lines coming off that, just kind of flick it out like that, and just make that dark in the middle, and then kind of fade that out. So we want it at its darkest at the bottom here. And then kind of just fade it out like this. And I'll just try and blend that a bit more with some more hot pink. then I'm just going to add a little bit of indigo at the very, very bottom here. And just blend that. Just to give it a bit more of a 3D look, like it goes right in at the bottom. Just gone slightly over there. Okay, so I'll go around and finish those petals and then we'll move on to the middle.
Trying to live another day, like the mothers of Brazil find their way. We're all on our own, but you're the most beautiful I've ever known. You're a beautiful sight in the summer night. And you can't.
So I've decided at the bottom here, if you can see the difference between these and these, I'm putting, I've got the pomegranate again, and I'm doing a harsh line at each side against the white like that, so it kind of looks like the petals turning out, and that's like a white outer edge. Okay, for the center of this flower, I'm going to start again with white in the middle. White blob in the middle, fade it out. And then I'm going to use this cheruse, I think it's pronounced, and it's number 989. I'm going to go around the edge, just a light layer over the white. And just do exactly the same as I did with the other flower centers, and I'm going to fade this out. Darker to the edge. On the very outside I'm using moss green number 1097. Edge with that, and then blending that edge slightly. I'm just going to take that moss green a little bit. I'm just going to blend that a little bit further in because I feel as though it's too light. I need another. I'm just going to fade that in a little bit more.
Okay,
so that's the three flowers finished. I hope you've enjoyed the tutorial. If you have, please give me a like underneath and subscribe to my channel. And if you click the little bell icon, which is next to the subscribe button, you'll be notified every time I upload a new video. So thank you very much for watching.